I've written this down and I'm reading it because I'm not good at speaking at the top of, off the top of my head, and I don't want to leave anything out. This is what happened to me, and it's a message to everyone that hears it. When I was a child, I was introduced to many different religions and began to realize that they were all saying pretty much the same things. They just had different ways of expressing it. When I realized this, I began putting it all together. In a sense, the majority wins. If two were saying one thing and one was saying something else that contradicted it, chances are that one was not the correct belief. And because of Buddhism, I was fascinated with the possibilities that the mind was capable of. In putting all of this together, I came up with the same belief system that George Lucas did for the Jedi. It was about the same time that he was doing it, maybe a little bit sooner. I was about 7 at the time. Later on in life, age 15, I began an intensive meditation routine and started being able to do some interesting things, such as astral projection, telepathy, telekinesis, and prophetic dreaming. I also began to remember past lives, a war in space, and my soul name. I envisioned a symbol for my soul name as well. It's a C and an S joined together. About 10 years later, I came across that same symbol on somebody's door. When I asked the woman of the house, she said it was a Jewish G. I also remember a planet that I've only heard one person mention in 20 years of looking. This person is Bashar. But he speaks of it as a city, where I know of it as a planet, and I also remember a city on that planet named Anira. In 1991, I moved into my godparents' house. From the odd feelings that I got there, I believed it was haunted. A friend of mine convinced me to make a Ouija board. I did, and we both used it and made contact. About a week after that, I woke up in the middle of the night, unable to move, with what looked like a glowing square box on my chest. It felt like something was trying to get in me, push my soul out of the way. After what seemed like an eternity, I seen my legs come up through the blanket. They were glowing, and I was able to kick this thing off of me. After that, I was able to move again. A little while after that, that friend of mine began telling me about me, the past lives that I knew a bit about already, the things that I did and things that I was able to do in my first life. He said he was a being that had possessed my friend and that he couldn't stay long because his being here was like a beacon to other beings. At one point, he said that he got a visit from two beings dressed in black. They were looking for me, but they seemed satisfied when he told them he had not contacted me. I believe this being tried to possess me first after we messed around with the Ouija board, but my belief in myself prevented it from doing so. So it went on to my friend. Near the end of our contact, about 6 months, it said it was a member of the group of 7, and that this group created the timelines, but were not happy with the way things turned out and have been trying to change them ever since. The feeling I got was that it was lying and that they did not create the timelines, but they were trying to change them. And they wanted me to stop trying to remember my past lives. They almost seemed scared at me remembering. It forced me into a deal to stop remembering, and I will be reunited with my soulmate to have a normal life before the war gets here. I firmly believe that if I did not agree to what it wanted, that it would have thrown me off the cliff that we were standing on at the time. After some research, in about 2001, I found a paper on the higher-ups of the New World Order. It said that the leaders of the New World Order take orders from channeled demons calling themselves the Group of Seven. I think they did not want me to remember because I know what the war is about. Scientists have said that the sun, stars in general, would be an excellent source of hydrogen for power, if we could find a way to harness it. And yes, it would be. But if you take hydrogen from the sun, it shortens that sun's life and will cause the sun and solar system to die out prematurely. Scientists have recently discovered there are solar systems in the universe that are dying out prematurely, and we are calling this galactic stripping. There has also been footage from NASA that shows something near our sun and appears to be drawing plasma from the sun. The war is about the same thing as the war here. Greed and power versus sustainable, renewable energy. Now you know what the war is about, and that it is here now. We're here to fight this war, not out in space, but here on the ground, by making our leaders choose the right path. The Bible says, as above, so below. If the right path is chosen by our leaders, our solar system will be saved.